Back on the main event, ready for our feature matchup this week, the Z-Man against Greg the Hammer Valentine. It wasn't too long ago on one of our television programs that the Z-Man was attacked by Greg Valentine.
And now the Hammer! Valentine! And Terrence Taylor, Valentine putting on the figure four! The referee going out of the way! Z-Man desperately needs some help, he's been doubled!
And the Hammer tried to break his legs with that figure four leg lock. But this matchup is one-on-one, Misty. Let's give us an unbiased opinion. I know you like the Z-Man. What do you think about this match?
Well, just because I really, really, really like the Z-Man doesn't mean I'm going to be, like, unbiased.
Okay, so go ahead and pick something.
Z-Man to win.
What do you think about this matchup, Meg?
I think Valentine has a tremendous amount of experience. He is the veteran. He is a brutal competitor. But I think if Z-Man can keep that aerial attack, that high-flying movement going, that he could come out victorious.
Don't forget Greg Valentine, one half of the U.S. Tag Team Champions, along with the TaylorMade Man, another one of your favorites. And, of course, Z-Man and Marcus Alexander Bagwell making a stand after those U.S. Tag Team belts. Should be a tremendous matchup. The Z-Man against Greg Valentine. It's our feature event. Let's go to the ring for the ring introductions of this matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following challenge match, it is set for one fall. Introducing first one half of the WCW United States Tag Team Champions, weighing in 256 pounds from Seattle, Washington, Greg the Hammer Valentine!
Greg Valentine. What a pro. Back to Tony Gillen we go.
His opponent coming down the aisle, weighing in at 242 pounds from Minneapolis, Minnesota, the Z-Man!
Z-Man always gets a great ovation, Magnum, each and every arena he comes into.
The Z-Man is full of energy. The fans love him. He loves being there. And I can't wait to see this great main event because Greg Valentine is such a veteran of the sport. And Z-Man is so determined to make his way to the top. Somebody's going to have to give here, and I'm going to be interested to see who it is.
There's a Z-Man fan and a WCW fan. Hello to you, and hello to all of our great fans who join us each and every Sunday night here on TBS, the main event. Wherever you are, all across this great land, we talk a lot about the Omni, but we also want to remind you that we have some tremendous wrestling events coming your way. For instance, we're going to be in St. Joe, Missouri, tonight for Gate WCW action. Collar and elbow tie-up. I want to say hello to all of our great fans up at St. Joe. And if you live in Atchison, Kansas, make it across the river there to see WCW action at the Civic Arena. We'd love to see you there. Valentine, you know, it goes back to the case where we were talking about stay away from the power. Z-Man moved out of the way that time, and that's what he's got to do. He's got to move.
Because Valentine is going to try to utilize that ground attack. Z-Man trying to throw the drop kicks, certainly missing his mark. Neither man is really connected with his heavy artillery yet.
Well, you can say that again. That's heavy artillery, though, and that's a big vertical suplex. Valentine always has been a guy to make a suplex look so easy.
Well, he has built low to the ground. His center of gravity is in such a position that he's able to really capitalize on his strength. And Z-Man is going to have to get away from allowing himself to be held down like this, because Valentine will bear that weight down on you. He'll take advantage of his height, his structure, and he knows how to do that from being the veteran that he is, where Z-Man wants to keep things moving. He wants to utilize those aerial attacks that he's known for. That was a nice drop kick. And that's another nice drop kick. That's the kinds of things Z-Man needs to do to be victorious.
Valentine immediately after those drop kicks, not a bad move at all by going on the floor. It's not the most honorable thing to do, and more times than not, fans will boo you. But you really serve, and so many announcers say, well, there's no timeout in pro wrestling, and I say bunk to that, because in effect, you are getting a timeout when you delay on the floor like that.
Exactly. You know, you're talking about a philosophical question, but it's sometimes very smart to break the rhythm of your opponent. If he's got things going his way, the only way to break the count, to break the action, is to take a little ride out on the floor. And right now, obviously, Z-Man has got things going the way he wants. The little backup and regroup session that Valentine had there wasn't successful for him.
A full arm drag and twist applied by Z-Man. You can only wonder what the strategy is here now.
You know, Valentine's the kind of wrestler who it takes him a little while to get warmed up. I watched him over the years. He isn't real comfortable until he breaks a sweat, kind of settles in. And he is relentless in his attack. You know, the referee trying to get a clean break there obviously didn't get one. And he's taking advantage of those big shoulders to the midsection of the Z-Man, getting that punishment in just on the verge of being counted out and disqualified by the referee, but still working within the rules. Just that borderline type action.
Big forearm blows. You take a good look at Greg Valentine. And the Z-Man finds himself in a lot of trouble here on TBS. Agility over the top. He's got him. But he couldn't hook a leg that time. And Valentine easily escaped. And Valentine, Magnum, I can see that one coming.
And see, those are the kind of mistakes Z-Man can't afford to make. He made a great agility move there out of the corner. But as you said, he didn't hook the leg, which may have allowed him to get the 1-2-3. But then taking right back off to the ropes, trying to utilize his speed again. Valentine was very screwed and sidestepped him, shot him to the floor, and that kind of punishment will take its toll on you in the long run.
Fans don't appreciate these moves. That is where he got his nickname, those forearms called the hammer on the chest of the Z-Man, who is having trouble catching his breath here. Good move, trying to get back in the ring because Valentine was on him. Z-Man here trying to use the rope. Sunset flip. Can he get him over? He cannot. Too much weight there.
Well, Valentine is still too strong. He's got to wear him down a little bit. As I said, even though he moves a little slower in the ring, he has got a tremendous amount of endurance, and he is such a punisher. They named him the Hammer a long time ago, back before it was fashionable, because of his relentless punishing of all his opponents. He just bangs away at you until he wears you down to nothing. And he is really taking the fight to the Z-Man here.
Driving the knee right to the small of the back now. Greg Valentine. Don't forget, fans, tickets available at the Omni Box Office and all Ticketmaster locations for Sunday, April 12th. We saw Valentine try to injure the Z-Man. Valentine is that type of competitor. He would love to hear you submit, and that's what type of move a figure four leg lock is, a submission move.
And it is a tremendously painful position to be in. I've had the misfortune of having been there before, and unless you can get to the ropes, it is almost impossible to turn that particular maneuver around. Z-Man, you see here, is taking a tremendous amount of punishment, and you can see Greg working his way down that lower body, getting those legs in a compromising position, and you know that he's got that figure four leg lock in the back of his mind that he's trying to set up.
3 points of attack right here for Valentine. The lower back and both knees, putting a strain on both knees of Z-Man. Each time holding on and just leveling Z-Man. Z-Man trying to get to the bottom rope here. He is there.
And he's made it to the ropes. I mean, that is the only way out for him in this particular situation. And he needs to get a little breather here so he can get his momentum going back like he needs. He's taking a tremendous amount of punishment.
But Z-Man has always been his characteristic, never says die. Oh, boy. Valentine punted him like a football that time. Oh, look at that. What an awesome move that was.
I mean, dropping an elbow with 255 pounds behind it is too much for anybody to take.
Z-Man got the way to Valentine going over top. Executed the back body drop, but Z-Man's back is still hurting, and so's his neck. And Valentine is relentless here.
Well, Tony, I have to wonder how much of this punishment he can continue to take before he cracks. I mean, the hammer is very focused here. He is working on the small of the back. He's dropping everything but the kitchen sink on him. The Z-Man is still kicking out. But I got to wonder how long he can take this kind of punishment without falling in.
Z-Man and Marcus Alexander Bagwell have become not only a very popular team, but a very successful one in WCW. And, of course, Valentine, one half of the U.S. Tag Team Champs, along with the TaylorMade Man, maybe one of the most fundamentally sound teams you'll find in WCW. Not maybe, they are. He missed the hammer, but he wastes a lot of time up top there.
And see, there's where he made his mistake. He got away from his ground attack. He went to a high-risk maneuver that allowed Z-Man to make that move. And a little move like that could turn everything around.
Right hand, cross of the face here to the other side. Now pick up, high back body drop.
Z-Man's got it where he wants it now. He needs to turn it on. If he backs off, Valentine could stop him again.
Chop to the chest. Into the corner. Drop kick to the face. Hammer goes down, Matt. Go ahead.
That was right on the money. Z-Man's roaring now. He needs to keep it going. He could have a tremendous upset victory here.
Did not need to look to the fans that time.
That hesitation factor. I mean, you cannot stop when you have things going your way. Momentum can change in the blink of an eye. And just that quickly, Valentine was able to counter him. And now he's setting him up right back on that leg. This could spell some trouble.
Valentine seizing the moment, so to speak. He's ready for the figure four. That was the prelude to it. No question about it. Here we go. Figure four leg lock. Nope, it was a headbutt to the midsection that the fans didn't appreciate. Valentine now with the elbow. He's got it. He's making sure he is down.
Valentine's still got a tremendous amount of artillery left.
By Z-Man.
He's got him hooked.
And he beat it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, the Z-Man.
A tremendous one, has to be considered somewhat of an upset, Magnum.
There's a lot of people around the world must consider this an upset right now. Z-Man took a tremendous amount of punishment in the hands of the hammer. But here you see the hammer stepping in, getting ready to put on that patented figure four leg lock. And the Z-Man capitalizing. It's a small package inside cradle. He's got the leg hooked, and it's over. One, two, three. The hammer has got to go crazy here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.